cool.
Okay, so we're going to start by talking about DNA replication, which is the process where DNA is replicated to form two identical copies. The first step would be DNA double helix is unwinded by enzymes.
So in the second step, the free nucleotides bind to the strands according to complementary base pairing. And then after that's done, the DNA polymerases check the new strands for the correct pairing.
And we're going to ask for a member of the audience to help us with this. So, if you don't mind.
So right now we're matching up the free nucleotides to the strand that's been unwinded. Okay, so now that that's done, now we have two copies that are formed, and the cell is now able to pass on genetics when it's going to divide, since there's two copies of the DNA. Okay.
Now we're going to be talking about polymerase chain reaction, which is PCR. That means the replication of DNA outside the living cell. The first step is that DNA portions are located at a crime scene.
So the second step is that a target DNA is placed into a thermal cycler, which is the machine they use to do PCR.
The third step is inside the thermal cycler, temperature regulates to the cycles of polymerase DNA replication.
So now this picture is demonstrating how the cycles work. So with the first cycle, you have your target DNA, and then that's copied, and now you have two copies. And in the second cycle, your copies are copied, so now you have 4, and then 16, and then you have 32, and it grows exponentially. After about 32 cycles, you would have almost a billion copies of DNA.
Yeah, but the fourth step is multiple cycles produce multiple copies of the DNA, and PCR can be used for genetic fingerprinting of the subject as it amplifies the sample.
Which this means that there's more copies that you can test and work with.
Thank you very much.